Luxury is not only having the money and buying it, because I can assure you, I have seen people who have the money, full, they can wear head to toe luxury, but they look like a plain cartoon. My name is Sonal Maherali, Kenya's first, and I think currently the only luxury blogger and vlogger and YouTuber. I grew up in a very humble home, humble beginnings. I would not even say humble, if I have to be brutally honest. I grew up with a lot of hardship, not the hardship that an average Indian Kenyan girl goes through. Then working and then finding this man who comes to sell insurance one fine day in 98 or 99, whom I completely hated his first sight.
Why?
I just found him very arrogant. He was a typical British arrogant man. It started from there, and then he just whisked me away within 2 years, and here I am, Cinderella. And I still remember the first date he ever took me on. I was wearing flip-flops, and he mentioned nice feet, and the first present was a shoe. So how can I not be Cinderella? I am a very passionate, humble, elegant,
beautiful,
outspoken,
yes,
bold, unapologetic. Completely raw and real person.
Yes.
What you see is what you get. I have no time to sugarcoat my words. If you want that, go to a bakery. With me, you will only get what SM has to give you. Either you take it or you leave it. I think I've always been that person who has looked, who has always wanted something creative in terms of fashion. I'd cut up clothes, do anything, whatever I had and handed to me, I would use that to create or feel good about myself wearing it.
Yes.
My shoes do not define me or my personality. My home does not. Give you a tour of the closet. And as you can see, it's filled to the brim. I have more shoes lying everywhere. This is like my peaceful place. There's a whole video on this. I think the Sabyasachi collaboration with Christian. They're called Pipto Sachi, a history of India and French coming together in one shoe. And these are only, they're only available in Madrid. They're exclusive for Spain. There's this side. I'm a full-time housewife, full-time mom. Of course, I have great help, my nannies, and I could not do it without them.
When your kids see mom putting pieces together, these beautiful shoes and bags, what are some of the things they do?
They actually imitate me. They come and say to me, oh my God, hi Sonal Maherali, I am such a big fan of yours. Because there's no place I travel, I don't meet a fan. Even right now, I just got back from Mumbai, the airport.
Yes.
I saw your name on the passenger list. I'm so happy to meet you. And I think they're also very young to understand what I do, but they know the love I have for shoes and fashion. And they shall slowly understand it better as they grow up. And they are girls after all, so you can imagine.
Does price ever matter?
Yes, price does matter, of course, because, like again I said, people think that I buy everything that I want. I wish I could, but of course I have a good head over my shoulders. I have an allocated budget for myself, and I say, okay, this is what I will buy, what I want. As we speak, I have a huge text message, WhatsApp, from my SA in London, who sent me all the latest shoes right now, which I'm avoiding to look at because right now I'm off budget, okay? For 4 years, I've been going to every store, Monaco, London, Paris, Dubai, Bangkok, every store in the world, Italy. Luxury is not only having the money and buying it, because I can assure you, I have seen people who have the money, full, they can wear head to toe luxury, but they look like a plain cartoon. Luxury is an experience. Luxury is the way you eat, the way you sit. Luxury is a personality. So I wouldn't pin it down to a commodity.
Yeah.
Luxury is a way of life. Why? Because not everything that is luxurious is going to be mine and suit my personal style.
Mm-hmm. Obviously, there are some moments when you felt, you know, like, hey, I don't want to wake up today. I don't want to do this. I don't even want to wear any of these shoes. How do you deal with some of the lowest moments that you have had in your life?
3 years ago, mm-hmm. I just had my fourth child. My mom was diagnosed with terminal cancer.
I'm sorry.
And all my friends bolted on me. I took a dip. I did not want to dress up. I didn't think to shower was important. For who and for what? Pain is good because you grow through it. Pain makes me who I am today, and that's why I can sympathize with the people who go through it. And I think so many of my fans love me for that reason, yeah. Because I might not be at your party, mm-hmm. but I will be there when you're in pain. Yeah. And be authentic, because the time someone sniffs that you are not what you portray to be, then you have everything to lose. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to change being me, the real me. I'm not going to be your version of me you want. I'm not going to sell you the toothpaste from Australia and be unauthentic because it's filling my pockets. Mm-hmm. I won't. We all have our own lanes. I stuck to luxury. I found a niche. I was looking for luxury content on YouTube in Kenya and I found none. And that's when I said, okay, mm-hmm. I come in. So I found my niche, you do you and I do me. Mm-hmm. I get people saying to me, and I have a global audience, and I get them saying to me, oh my God, you're so from such a poor country, there are children who don't have clothes on your mm-hmm. streets. And I'm like, my God, pay us a visit. We are so not what you think we are. We are capable of luxury and you shall see us there. Mm-hmm. I will not rest until I see Africa on the map, because mm-hmm. if Africa is capable of luxury and I'm not seeing it there, then you will see Sonal Maherali launching her own luxury for Africa.
For Africa,
yes.
And by an African.
And globally, and by a Kenyan African. I'm very much the East African. Yes. My dad was Tanzanian, my mom is Kenyan.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Talking about meeting top designers, Christian, who are also some of the people that you met and you are just blown away?
I can only vouch for Christian. I have an obsession, an unapologetic love affair with him. He knows it, everybody knows it, and that's it.
If there's a mom right now watching you and she feels like just because she's a mom and she gave birth and she has kids and now she's a full-time house mom and she felt like, I can't go on with my passion, I can't continue following what I love because I have to do this, what would you like to tell that mom?
You cannot give others from an empty cup. Fill yourself first, love yourself, put yourself forward. Do what you like while still maintaining the other areas of the life. How will you serve from an empty cup? Mm-hmm. You'll burn out.
You'll burn out.
Happy mom, happy home. Mm-hmm. Happy children. Unhappy mom, unhappy home. It's very simple.